After studying this module, you will be able to know substance related disorders and differentiate between substance dependence and abuse. Identify the prevalence and clinical picture of alcohol abuse and dependence. Evaluate treatment of alcohol abuse disorder. Defining substance related disorders. Substance related disorders are related to the misuse of psychoactive substance or drugs. People use various substances to reduce physiological pain and alter the state of consciousness. Many people have tried to quit smoking, and some people are not get through the day without several drinks of alcohol and beer. Smoking, alcohol and drug affect the central nervous system of the individual. It relieves their tension and give them happiness and euphoric feelings. Substance abuse is a maladaptive patterns of substance use. It brings significant impairment in the daily functioning of the individual. Repeated use of substance brings negative effects in social relationships and recurrent legal problems related to substance. Despite these problems, their initial effects are pleasing, and this seems the root cause of substance-related disorders. Clinical description, prevalence, and effects of substance-related disorders. Prevalence of alcoholism varies, ranging from 1 and 550 out of 1,000. Bang, 1991, studied that in 104 villages of Maharashtra, 1 lakh men consume alcohol and 1/5 are addicts. In a recent study conducted by ICMR in Bangalore, 1.2% of men suffering from alcohol abuse. The meta-analysis by Reddy and Chandrasekhar revealed prevalence of 6.9 out of 1,000 for India, with urban and rural rates of 5.8 and 7.3 out of 1,000 population. The rates among men and women were 11.9 and 1.7 respectively. In a community-based study conducted by Gujarat in four areas, rural, semi-rural, slum, and urban habitual alcohol users accounted for 9%. He found that 10 to 60% of school students, medical, personnel, and industrial workers use alcohol. He said that due to the high consumption of alcohol, rate of hospital admission is increasing. The prevalence of alcohol use among women is found to be 0.5% due to the high consumption of alcohol. Road accidents are increasing. They cause harm to themselves. First, we need to outline that what we mean by substance use, substance intoxication, substance abuse, and dependence. The term substance refers to chemical compounds that are ingested to alter mood or behavior. Although you might first think of drugs such as cocaine and heroin, this definition also includes more commonplace legal drugs such as alcohol, the nicotine found in tobacco, and the caffeine in coffee, soft drinks, and chocolate. These so-called safe drugs also affect mood and behavior. They can be addictive. To understand substance-related disorders, we must first know what it means to ingest psychoactive substance which alters mood, behavior, or both, to become intoxicated or high, to abuse these substances, and to become dependent upon or addicted to them. Substance use. Substance use is taking psychoactive drugs or substance in an appropriate amount and it has not harmful impact on the daily functioning, like going to college, to office, to social relationships, drinking a less quantity of alcohol, taking a cup of coffee in the morning, and the smoking a cigarette to relax, and occasional use of illegal drugs are example of substance use. Intoxication. Intoxication is our biological reaction to ingest substance or getting high, is referred to as intoxication. Level of intoxication depends on how much the drug is taken. and the individual's physiological reactions. Common physiological reactions towards intoxication are impaired perception, judgment, variation in mood, motor ability. Substance abuse. Substance abuse is pathological misuse of a substance such as illegal drugs, alcohol, and nicotine. The individual is involved in potentially harmful behavior such as driving dangerously after having a high quantity of alcohol and is always using it despite continuous psychological, social, and health problems. DSM-4 TR diagnostic criteria for substance abuse. A maladaptive pattern of substance use leading to clinically significant impairment or distress as manifested by one or more of the following during the same 12-month period. Recurrent substance use resulting in a failure to fulfill major role obligation at work, school, or home. For example, repeated absence or poor work performance related to substance use, substance-related absence, suspensions or expulsion from school, neglect of children or household. Recurrent substance use in situations in which it is physically hazardous, for example, driving an automobile or operating a machine when impaired by substance use. Recurrent substance-related legal problems like arrest for substance-related disorder conduct, continuous substance use despite having persistent or recurrent social or interpersonal problems caused by the effects of substance, arguments with the spouse about consequences of intoxication like physical fights. The symptoms have never met the criteria for substance dependence for this class of substance. Substance dependence. It is an addiction of drug. It is extremely difficult to give up it. The individual is physiologically dependent on the drug. He needs the drug in much more quantity to have the same kind of impact, tolerance, and physiologically behave in a negative way. If the drug is not provided to the person, tolerance and withdrawal are responses of the individual towards the drug being ingested. If the person is given coffee in the morning, he starts experiencing headaches and he may be going through the caffeine withdrawal, vomiting, nausea, aches, fever, and diarrhea are withdrawal symptoms. Some drugs have not any withdrawal symptoms when you stop consuming them. These drugs are marijuana or LSD. Cocaine withdrawal has patterns that includes anxiety, lack of motivation, and boredom. DSM-4-TR diagnostic criteria for substance dependence. A maladaptive pattern of substance use leading to clinically significant impairment or distress as manifested by three of the following occurring at any time in the same 12-month period. Tolerance as defined by either of the following. A need for marked increased amount of the substance to achieve intoxication or desired effects. Marked diminished effect with continued use of the same amount of the substance. Withdrawal as manifested by either of the following. The characteristic withdrawal syndrome for the substance. Like the substance is often taken in a large amount or over a longer period than it was intended. So there is a persistent desire or unsuccessful effort to cut down or control substance use. A great deal of time is spent in activities necessary to obtain the substance. Like for example, visiting multiple doctors, driving long distances, use the substance, for example, chain smokers or recover from its effects. Important social, occupational or recreational activities are given up or reduced because of substance use. The substance use is continued despite knowledge of having a persistent or recurrent physical or psychological problem that is likely to have been caused by the substance. Diagnostic issues. In early DSM, alcoholism and drug abuse were not treated as separate disorders. Instead, they were categorized as sociopathic personality disturbances because substance use was seen as a symptom of the problem. It was considered as a sign of moral weakness, and influence of genetic and biological was hardly recognized. DSM-IV term, substance-related disorders, indicates several subtypes of diagnosis for each substance, including dependence, abuse, intoxication, withdrawal, or a combination of these. These distinctions help to clarify the problem and focus on the treatment on the appropriate aspect of the disorder. Substance can be grouped into 5 general categories: depressants, stimulants, opioids, hallucinogens, and other drugs of use. Depressants are those drugs which induce relaxation and behavior sedation. These include hypnotic drugs like benzodiazepine and barbiturates, and alcohol and sedative drugs. Stimulants make us more active and enhance our mood. Caffeine, cocaine, nicotine are stimulant drugs. Opioids produces euphoric feelings and analgesic in the person. Morphine, opium, and opioids are the example. Hallucinogens, the effect of hallucinogens are the delusions and hallucinations. It also alters sensory perception of the individual. Other drugs of abuse. Substances which do not come under single category are inhalants, steroids, and prescription medications. These drugs produce various kind of psychoactive effects. Depressants suppress the central nervous system activity. It reduces the physiological arousal and induces relaxation. Antiemetic drugs, sedatives, and alcohol are depressants. Alcohol abuse and dependence. Alcohol abuse and alcohol dependence are two different disorders. The symptoms of alcohol abuse are social withdrawal, like marital disruption, deprivation from family, and disharmony with friends, and occupational effects such as absent from the office, and they do not show tolerance and withdrawal symptoms. Individuals who are dependent on alcohol show severe symptoms such as withdrawal or tolerance. The major effects of the dependence are anxiety, depression, and sleeplessness. Alcohol is a depressant, and its initial effects are stimulation. Initially, alcoholics believe that it will reduce tension and increase social competence. Alcohol depresses certain areas of brain. Their cognitive abilities are affected. Their judgment and motor coordination becomes impaired. Their reaction time is slowed. They come across major road accidents. Prevalence and cost of alcohol abuse and dependence. Alcohol is especially frequent among college-age adults. In a survey conducted by Mohan et al. 1992, and Delhi found that 26% of the residents living in Delhi slums were substance abuse, the majority involving alcohol. In another study conducted in or around Bangalore by ICMR, 1.2% of men were found to suffer from alcohol dependence syndrome. The prevalence rate among men is found to be more than women. Estimates suggest that 20-30% hospital admission is related to alcohol consumption. More men than women died in alcohol-related accidents. The clinical picture of alcohol and dependence. There are many common physiological consequences of alcohol. They face cognitive deficits like forgetting, nausea, fatigue, hangovers, and headaches. They have disastrous family life. They face many social and health problems. Short-term effects of alcohol. When an individual consumes alcohol, it passes through small intestines and is absorbed into blood. Then it is broken down into liver, and alcohol absorbs very quickly into the system, and its removal is slow. It affects the central nervous system of the brain and neurotransmitters, especially GABA, which reduces the tension of the person. It also increases the secretion of serotonin and dopamine. It increases the pleasure feeling in the person. Alcohol inhibits the glutamate receptors, which is responsible for memory loss and deficits in thinking. Long-term effects of prolonged alcohol abuse. There are many adverse effects of prolonged use of alcohol on each tissue and organ of the individual. It provides empty calories to the person and reduces his appetite. It do not provide any nutrition to the body. It impairs the digestive system of the person and reduces his capacity to absorb vitamins. Deficiency of vitamin B complex may bring amnesia syndromes. Severe loss of recent and long-term memory occurs in the person. Long-term use of alcohol brings protein deficiency and further contribute to the development of liver cirrhosis. Long-term use of alcohol damages heart, pancreas, and hemorrhages. In elderly people, it can cause dementia, which can cause a severe memory loss. Individuals who have chronically abused alcohol and they consume less quantity of protein leads to the development of liver cirrhosis. Alcohol affects the endocrine glands, heart, pancreas, hypertension, which creates hypertension and stroke. It also damages some parts of the brain. Heavy use of alcohol impairs memory. Mothers who consume alcohol during pregnancy give birth to infants of mental retardation. Even the moderate amount of alcohol taken during pregnancy affects the growth of fetus. Psychosocial effects of alcohol abuse and dependence. In addition to various physical problems, and excessive drinkers suffer from chronic fatigue, oversensitivity, and depression. The excessive use of alcohol eventually becomes counterproductive and can result to poor judgment and gradual personality deterioration. Behavior typically becomes like touchy, irritable, and unwilling to discuss the problem. Psychosis associated with severe alcohol abuse. Individuals who consume large quantity of alcohol suffer from delirium. They suffer from disorientation for place and time. Hallucinations are found in them, particularly of small, fast-moving animals like snakes, ant, rat. Acute fear, extreme suggestibility, in which a person can be made to see almost any animal if its presence is merely suggested. Marked tremors of the hand, tongue, lips. Other symptoms include perspiration, fever, a rapid and a weak heartbeat, a coated tongue, and a foul breath. Delirium typically lasts from 3 to 6 days and is generally followed by a sleep. A second alcohol-related psychosis is the disorder referred to as amnesia. Persons with this disorder may not recognize pictures, faces, rooms, and other objects are familiar. Biological factors in the abuse and dependence on alcohol. Biological and psychosocial factors contribute to the development of alcohol dependence and abuse. Many researchers view alcohol abuse as a maladaptive pattern of adjustment to the stressful life events. Some researchers emphasized sociocultural factors like availability of alcohol and approval to it leads to alcohol dependency. The development of alcohol addiction is a complex process involving many elements, constitutional vulnerability and environmental encouragement, as well as the unique properties of certain psychoactive substance, the neurobiological addiction. Alcohol produces euphoria by stimulating limbic dopamine pathways. This neural system is involved in functions such as control of emotions, memory, and gratification. Alcohol produces euphoria by stimulating this area in the brain. Genetic vulnerability. The possibility of genetic predisposition to developing alcohol abuse problem has been widely researched. Many experts today agree that genetics play an important role in developing sensitivity to alcohol. Alcohol clearly runs in the families. Researchers has shown that some people, such as sons of alcoholic who were adopted by other non-alcoholic families, has also provided useful information. Genetics alone is not the whole story and the exact role it plays in the development of alcoholism remains unclear. This issue continues to debate and some researchers are clear about the primary role of genetics in alcoholism. Although some genetic factors are implicated in the etiology of alcoholism, but it is not clear that genetic alone will account for the full range of alcoholic. Genetic influences and learning. Genetic factors along with learning leads to the development of alcohol abuse and addiction. The individual is exposed to the environment where he gets sufficient amount of alcohol before he gets addicted to it. He is living in the family where initial as well as prolonged use of alcohol was promoted. People become conditioned to alcohol and tend to respond in a particular way as a result of learning. Psychosocial casual factors in alcohol abuse and dependence. Persons of alcohol addiction is not only physiologically dependent upon it, but also psychologically. A number of psychosocial factors lead to alcohol abuse and dependence. Failure in parental guidance. It was found that dysfunctional family relationships are implicated in the abuse and dependence on alcohol. Children whose parents are addicted to alcohol, they are vulnerable to developing alcohol abuse themselves. Warm and stable family relationships are important in healthy development of children. Children who are exposed to negative life events and circumstances, they are vulnerable to developing alcohol abuse. Their elders at home do not provide them any guidance. They tend to get involved in maladaptive behavior such as alcohol abuse and addiction. Psychological vulnerability. Researchers have found that psychological factors lead to alcohol abuse. Some alcoholics are found to be emotionally immature. They react to their failures with inferiority. They are found to be impulsive and aggressive. They require an inordinate amount of praise. They are unsure about their abilities. Stress, tension reduction, and reinforcement. Alcoholics drink as it reduces their stress and tension. They are found to be dissatisfied with their life. Alcohol induces positive effect in the alcoholic and it works as a reinforcement. Expectations of social success. Young alcoholics start drinking alcohol under peer pressure and they become famous among them. Expectations play an important role both in the initial start and maintenance of drinking. They expect that it will reduce their stress and anxiety and increase the pleasure feeling in them. Marital and other intimate relationships. Person with marital problems and less intimate relationships tend to develop drinking alcohol. Excessive drinking starts during the problem in marital and intimate relationships. Breakup of marital relationships is highly stressful for some persons. The stress of divorce leads to increased alcohol abuse. Socio-cultural factors. Alcohol use is a pervasive component in the social life in Western civilization. Social events involve around alcohol use, and alcohol use before and during meals is commonplace. People consume alcohol because it enhances euphoric feelings and reduces their stress. Researchers have found psychological and socio-cultural factors in the high intake of alcohol. Cultural factors has effect on the consumption of alcohol. Muslims and Orthodox Jew religious values prohibit the use of alcohol. The incidence of alcohol is less among these people. Alcohol consumption is maximum among Europeans. France has the highest rate of alcoholism in the world. Treatment of alcohol abuse disorder. Individuals suffering from alcohol abuse are difficult to treat. Some of them leave the treatment in between and others refuse to admit that they have some problem. And treatment include detoxification, and physical rehabilitation, changing the thought process of the person that he can lead more useful life without taking alcohol. Medication, behavioral and psychological strategies are used to treat the patients of alcohol abuse. Use of medication in treating alcohol abusers. Biological approaches include a variety of treatment measures such as medication to reduce craving, to ease the detoxification process, and to treat co-occurring health and mental health problems that may underlie the drinking behavior. Medications to block the desire to drink. Anti-abuse a drug that causes violent vomiting when followed by ingestion of alcohol may be administered to prevent an immediate return to drinking. Medication is not proved to be effective in treating alcoholism because it has uncomfortable side effects. Another medication is naltrexone. It is proved to be helpful in reducing the craving for alcohol by blocking the pleasure producing effects of alcohol. Medications to reduce the side effects of acute withdrawal. Medicines are given to the individual to reduce the severity of withdrawal symptoms such as headaches, sleeplessness. Benzodiazepines are prescribed to the patient to treat the withdrawal symptoms. It may introduce addiction to some other substance. Detoxification is also used to treat acute withdrawal. Psychological treatment approaches. Detoxification is optimally followed by psychological treatment, including family counseling and the use of community resources related to employment and to other aspects of a person's social readjustment. Psychological treatment consists of cognitive behavioral therapy, environmental treatment, and group therapy. Group therapy. Spouse and children of the alcoholic abuser may be invited to join in a group therapy. Family members take the responsibility for cooperating in treatment. Such treatment also help them see new responsibilities. Such treatment also help them see new possibilities for coping with circumstances that have led to their difficulties. Environmental interventions. Environmental variables prove to be successful in treating the alcoholic. Usually, family members leave them because of their alcohol addiction and abuse. Behavioral and cognitive behavioral therapy. Behavioral and cognitive behavioral therapy is effective in treating the persons of alcohol addiction. In aversive conditioning, some noxious stimuli is given to the person with alcohol. This suppresses their drinking habit and alcoholic feel like vomiting after taking alcohol. Skill training is also used to treat young alcohol abusers. The person is given knowledge about the intake of alcohol. Skills are developed in situations associated with increased risk of alcohol use and thoughts are modified. Summary. Substance-related disorders are extremely common disorders. So they are related to the use of psychoactive drugs. DSM-4 distinguishes between substance dependence and substance abuse. Dependence means the person is physiologically dependent upon the drug. He needs it in much more quantity to have the same kind of impact. Alcohol is not only a psychoactive substance, but smokers also develop nicotine dependence. It brings psychological and physiological impairment in social, personal, and occupational functioning. Substance abuse has a variety of short-term and long-term effects on the individual. It includes poor perception, disastrous family relationships, difficulty in managing financial resources, and faces problem at workplace. Genetic and psychosocial factors play role in substance-related disorders. Some common factors that can lead to teenagers to abuse alcohol, smoking, and drugs are high level of stress, peer pressure, and disturbed relationship with the families.